In this video, I'm going to explain all the options available for context data categories. Let's create a new context data category. Context data category classifies files using NTFS tags or metadata. Configuration of this approach is resource intensive and requires proper testing. Therefore, we consider this approach to be an expert solution and do not recommend using this as the primary approach to DLP. When I expand the advanced options, I can enable additional features, like using metadata, user-based classification, and clipboard behavior. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to leave the default settings. Let's configure the data category. There are three main approaches for setting up a context data category. First, I set up a new application rule. When the rule is in testing mode, it logs the files that will be classified, but they don't actually get the tag. I switch it to tagging mode. Now I can choose an application category. All outputs of applications that belong to that category will be classified. A typical use case would be to tag outputs of CRM. Then I choose the file extensions I want to tag. You can also specify advanced options like keyword of file name, tagging action, and whether to include system files. This way, only files that have the keyword invoice in the file name will be classified. I can also choose tagging action and whether I want to include system files too. The second approach is creating a web rule. All files downloaded from a selected website will be classified. This rule is useful for customers who have their CRM and other applications on the web. You can add a whole category of websites or specify a single website. You can also use wildcard characters. Then specify the extensions of the file that will be tagged. In the advanced settings, you can choose to tag downloaded and opened files only, or all web content, including text copied from the site. The third approach allows you to define locations where sensitive files are stored and classify files in these locations. This is a good way to protect data if the customer is able to define such locations. For example, an engineering company that stores all their drawings on a shared network drive. Unlike the previous two rules, for this one you can choose specific computers or users for whom the rule will be applied. Then choose the paths and extensions. All files matching the extensions in all subfolders will be tagged. For this rule, you can set up task repetition and the task can be run as another user. You need to select specific computers. The task cannot be assigned to a group. Advanced settings are similar to the other rules. Here's how to check which files were classified. Switch to Records view and expand a data category.